Good evening, everybody, and welcome to another edition of Let's Play. I'm SonicBlu, and at this time I'm pulling open my Sega Saturn to bring you this Let's Play. Now, we've shown you Rise of the Dragon, and by special request, I've asked to do this game. And if you enjoy Cheech Marin, the comedy stylings of Monty Python, and dragons, you'll love this one. Mix all three of them together, and you've got Blazing Dragons.
I'm getting too old for this. Curse those humans. They're attacking the royal mines again. Knights of the Square Table, defend our family jewels!
We must defeat Sir George's men. Gas Flame, establish a defense perimeter. Bernevere, report on troop strength. Blaze, you and I will attack in formation Delta Tango Orange. Or better yet, let's just rush in and torch those buggers.
Or Camel Hawk!
Alright, now as our story opens up, I can already tell you off the bat, you play the role of Flicker the Dragon, a very hardly noticed dragon in the midst of a kingdom full of knights, a king, and a princess, a jester, and a chancellor. Your ultimate goal is to stop Sir George and his reign of terror, and do so in a comical but yet ingenious way. Can there ever be an ingenious way to do this? We'll find out on this game of Blazing Dragons. Let's play! Oh yeah, get used to seeing that loading screen. You'll see it a lot during this game.
The raid wasn't a complete loss, Sir George. We did lose 1,000 knights, but at least we made off with this extraordinary diamond.
It's half-eaten! Curse those dragons! Merlin, I want some fiendish advice. How can I make Camel Hawk mine?
My spies have just given me some new, deliciously diabolical information regarding the future of Camel Hawk.
My new alarming clock is a splendid invention, but adding the snooze lever was pure genius.
Flicker, hurry up, you lazy bag of dragon droppings. King Olfar's been waiting to see you.
I just want to test the snooze lever one more time. I'll be down in 9 minutes.
Fine. I'll tell the king, our absolute sovereign, master of all he surveyed, that you can't fit him into your busy schedule.
Whoa, hold your jingle bells. Tell the king I'm on my way. Maybe it's about my request to battle in the tournament tomorrow. If I can't win, Princess Flame will be forced to marry someone else.
Yes, needless to say, you have the hots for Princess Flame. Let's take the tail warmer. And just like any point-and-click game...
A good inventor always has his invention book.
You need inventory, so grab up everything you possibly can.
Hello, little friend. Anxious to show all the nice people what a well-trained moth you are? Pavlov, where are you going? You're setting a terrible example at the beginning of the game. Bad moth, bad.
Well, at least we got a jar out of it. I think that's all that we can take. Now, your cursor makes up of the grab icon, the talk icon, the look icon, and the walk icon. Your A and C buttons scroll back and forth between them, and the B button executes. Very simple control. The other two buttons we'll look at are the L1 and L2 buttons, but you don't have to worry about them right now. We've grabbed everything we can, so let's book it on out of here and find out what the king wants. While we're here, let's take this candelabra and put it in your inventory bag. And we don't really need to go into the library right now, but soon we will.
Flicker, about tomorrow's tournament, my answer is no.
Jeez, I was only an hour late.
The tournament is open only to dragon knights. You're not a knight. You're not even a squire. Knights of the square table, your attention, please.
Silence, please. Silence for the king. Pray silence. The king is speaking.
Shh. I'm sorry.
We must do something, Flicker. I refuse to marry one of these flaming idiots.
I'll try, Flame. I promise. Uh-oh. Visitors.
Humans in Camel Hot?
Greetings, King Smallfire. I sincerely regret to hear that you are finally retiring. When my entry in your tournament, the Black Dragon, wins and is crowned king, he will turn your hide into ladies' handbags and tight shoes.
What? Humans can't enter the tournament? I'm certain the Camel Hot law book will not allow such a thing. Chancellor?
You're undoubtedly right, sire. Chapter 3, Section 9, Paragraph 18 clearly states that humans shall not be eligible to participate in any tournament.
Take a bite out of that, haircut boy.
Unless, of course, they have a dragon to participate on their behalf.
Chancellor, I believe you're mistaken. Doesn't Chapter 3, Section 9, Paragraph 18 refer to an obscure law governing public snout-picking?
Yes, well, at one time it did, but I changed it. Accidentally. This is a sensitive matter of state, King Allfire. I really don't think the princess should be involved.
Quite right. Keep quiet, dearest.
Quibble while you may. Tomorrow, Camel Hot will be mine. Away, Mervyn!
Humans! Pah! We should have toasted the little pink bugs the moment they arrived.
Calm down! Our opponent can be defeated. Your mission is to bring back information about this mysterious black dragon.
Yes, sire!
Father, Flicker needs a mission.
Oh, okay. Flicker, I hereby command you to wash all the dirty dishes that have piled up in the royal kitchen. There you have it.
Oh, wacko.
Tally-ho, chaps! We have a black dragon to quash! That's an English word, you know.
Ooh, that blind idiot!
Gotta love it. Okay, now we gain control.
I see Sir Gasflame's been using room service again.
Alright. First things first, you'll notice that Flicker doesn't want to do dishes the traditional way.
I could most likely use this in case I make a mess, or perhaps for something else.
So you want to grab the mop, and you don't even need to put it in your bag, just put it right there.
Not only is that inappropriate, it's silly.
Right there.
It fits like it was made to go there. Now, if only I could get this thing to spin.
Flicker, I've got great news.
You're going to help me with the dishes?
No. If you're a knight, Daddy will have to let you compete in a tournament. To become a knight, you first need to have an existing knight take you on as a squire.
And then?
As a squire, you can journey into the Cave of Dilemma. Leave alive, and you're a knight. Good luck! Bye!
Well, that sure simplified things.
Alright, continuing on, go into your inventory bag. We're going to need to combine the two steam kettles together into one source of steam.
It's a perfect fit. So snug that no steam's escaping.
Finally, that tail warmer also doubles as a blower.
I love it when an invention comes together.
Dishpan claws are now a thing of the past.
Lo and behold, the automatic dishwasher. Now, how much would you pay for this miracle time saver? Don't answer, because I'm free to leave the castle.
What's all this, then?
Good day, Chancellor. This is my latest invention, the automatic dishwasher.
I see it's run off steam. Is it powerful?
As powerful as a dozen knights.
Fascinating. Perhaps later I can help you find some further uses for it.
All right, well, that was kind of unusual, but moving on. Okay, now, I don't think there's... Well, let me think. Well, let's do some exploring around the land now that we're free to leave. You can talk to her if you want to, but all she does is just give useless information.
I beg your pardon?
Yes? What can I do for you?
I need your help. I have to locate the Knights of the Square Table.
I've got a semi-enchanted map. It will show you where you want to go, even if you don't know you want to go there.
Well, at least she's good for something. She gave you a map. You're going to need it.
I beg your pardon?
Yes? What can I do for you?
What's the easiest way to become a squire?
Kiss some knight's butt flicker. It hurts, but it's worth it. Oh, heavens me, did I just say that?
Yes, you did.
Can I have some useless information?
There are only two things you can be sure of in life. Death and taxes. And that there are only two things in life you can be sure of. Wait a minute.
What are you knitting?
Oh, my little boy's grown another 2 feet since last week. I just can't keep up. Now, what can I do for you?
And anything else is pretty much useless as to the information she gives, so let's get out of here.
I have all the information I need.
Now, across the way, you'll find the Chancellor's room.
Hello, Chancellor. Nice flat. So light and airy.
You know I don't allow guests up here, Flicker. Please leave.
Well, okay.
Well, that was easy.
Hey, thanks for the hospitality.
Oh, don't worry. You'll be coming back in here sooner or later. Now let's get out of here and explore the land.
The map really is enchanted. I can see where all four knights have gone.
All right, well, let's just do some exploring first, and it gives you more of an insight on how to solve puzzles. Let me also say that this is one of those types of games where it is impossible to lose. There is no way to get game over unless, of course, you beat the game. Then you get a game over. But you can't die, you can't get hurt, you cannot restart, or, you know, you can't reach a point where you cannot pass the game. It's one of those types of games. Let's go up here and check out, see what's up with this knight.
Oh, just look at the time. King Allfire sent me on a mission and I've been here for hours. You're such a bad boy.
Hey, big guy. I can't control my burning feelings of candy love.
Okay, as you can see, this guy suffers from narcissism. You know, Narcissus. Falling in love with his, reflection.
People do stare at me, you know.
Hey, baby, jealousy is an ugly, ugly vibe.
Now, the best thing about this game is taking a look at everything to give you a better insight on what you need to do in order to pass certain puzzles.
She seems like a happy little frog, but I bet she's lonely being here all by herself.
Yeah, you got a frog.
That's Sir Blaze, the seriously vain. Mesmerized by the thing he loves the most.
Himself?
This tranquil pool must be enchanted. Sir Blaze's reflection has a mind of its own.
Maybe it's just that way. All right, well...
I really have to go.
In order to break his concentration, you have to break that reflection somehow. Check out this area, which is the Lady of the Lake.
The magical home of the Lady of the Lake. Look! Something magical's happening! Oh, what are the chances?
Oh, all this rubbish everywhere! What's a lady to do?
I got you now, fish lady. Speedy, quick!
Let me go!
Oh, no! That fisherman just caught the Lady of the Lake!
Now, that snotty, snooty, snubby.
Help me.
I couldn't. I'd get wet. And the last thing in the world I want to do is get wet.
Well, of course, you're a dragon, fire breather, getting wet, put out your fire. All right, so needless to say, we need to get over there at some point in the game, but we can't do it right now. But get a good insight, get a good look into your surroundings. And then the items you get will help you solve certain puzzles, certain obstacles. Let's go around here to where this knight is.
Come down here, wretched human! You come up here, myopic moron!
That's Sir Gasflame, the visually impaired. He's a powerful warrior, but his eyes are as weak as his intellect.
You...
I haven't seen the king this angry since that nasty business with the pea under the princess's mattress.
Ew. Oh,
Trivet
that pea.
So literal at times.
I thought he meant the other kind of pea.
King Allfire's tomato garden. It contains the most fertile soil in the kingdom.
Fertile soil.
I order you to surrender!
Pardon me, Sir Gasflame?
Huh? My word! A giant talking dandelion! Oh, Flicker, it's you!
Why do you refuse to wear glasses? Sir Bernavir wears them into battle. Do you think any less of him?
Of course I do! But he can use those large words to defend himself.
That's King Allfire up there.
Your sense of humor is warped. It's clear this is Castle Grimm, and that fuzzy blot up there is Sir George.
Talk to you later. I see you're busy attacking the wrong castle.
Come down here, wretched human!
Okay.
You come up.
Let's just get out of here and let them deal with their differences on their own. Okay, come down here.
How did Sir Bernavir wind up here? This is the home for the grimly insane, where they treat clinically depressed storybook characters.
Huh. Speaking
Magic
about peas.
Beans. This one looks good.
There we go. Right, let's just take that. Okay, you got a woman here who screams and cuts her own hair. What is wrong with her?
Excuse me, but your hair...
It's too long, I know. Otherwise, you never would have said such a thing.
Please calm yourself, miss.
Yablonowitz! Rapunzel Yablonowitz! And how can I be calm with all this long hair?
Oh, what long hair?
You don't know what it was like. Everywhere I turned, it was, Rapunzel, throw down your hair! Rapunzel, throw some more hair down! Hey, I didn't get any hair over here! Before long, I was throwing down hair all over the place. It was making me crazy!
That's exactly what I was thinking. Crazy.
Luckily, Dr. Fraud is a man who knows how to make a commitment. In fact, he's committed everybody here. He's really helped me see the light.
Getting the hair out of your eyes probably helped. Should you be outside? Unattended?
Yes, of course. I do the gardening around here. I trim the bushes, I trim the grass, I trim everything. Hey, you should have seen that beanstalk before I got to it.
Why are you so stressed about your hair?
My hair? If I don't keep it short, it'll grow down to the floor and then out the door.
But we're outside. Wouldn't it grow in the door?
Well, if you're gonna split hairs. Now, don't bother me. I've got to be ready with my clippers if it tries to grow.
Forget I said anything. Most people do.
All right, let's go on inside if you feel safe enough to deal with crazy people.
So, you think your mother is,
A dragon! Good sir, I don't have time for this.
Ah, you have a classic case of scale envy. Now, take off that silly costume.
This isn't a costume. I'm a dragon. And you, sir, are a fraud.
Yes, I am Dr. Sigmund Fraud, specialist in the disturbed, the confused, and the loony nut boys.
What a mess. Sir Bernavir's trapped.
Okay, you can stick around and talk to the crazies, but...
I say, that's a nice pipe.
Can't stop to talk. Have to play.
So the play's the thing. But why?
The rats! My playing is the only thing keeping the rats away. If I stop, they'll be all over me. It's horrible.
But I... That's a catchy little ditty. What's it called?
Do. It's called Keep the Rancid Rat at Bay. If one gets near, I fear my flesh he'll flay. It's an original composition.
Hmm. Is that a flute or a recorder?
It's neither. It's a pipe. I'm the Pied Piper. Get it?
I'll talk to you later. I see you're busy being insane.
Beware the rats. They're out there.
Excuse me?
Yes, what can I do for you?
I notice you're eating flies.
Indeed I am, dear boy. They're low in fat, high in fiber, and the way they buzz on the way down gives them a little added zing.
I didn't know humans enjoyed flies.
Neither did I. Oh, fancy that. Humans like the same things we frogs do.
Oh, so you're a frog?
More or less.
Aren't you cold?
Nudity leads to that. I usually wrap myself in a lily pad when I catch a chill, but that's a little impractical now.
If you don't mind me saying so, you look pretty human. For a frog, that is.
Hard to miss, isn't it? I blame the princess who kissed me last summer. Eccentric girl. Good family, though.
Is there anything I could do to help?
If you should come across a princess in an affectionate mood, do send her my way. Puckered up, if possible. And not too much lipstick. There's a good chap.
Sorry to bother you. I see you're eating.
Now, Sir Guinevere.
Psst! Sir Bernevere.
Oh, Sir Bernevere.
Do you mind? I am in the middle of a session with my patient.
Well, you're not going to get any help from them, so... Well, we see a connection already. The female frog that's up at the lake. And this human who once was frog. Keep that in mind. And now we've seen all three of the knights. This question mark here is the fourth knight, by the way, who won't come into play until later. So, let's take a look at what we can do right now. Oh, yes, and you can go to the village, you can go to the cave, but you can't do anything there because of the waterfall. Can't do anything there yet, so let's go... What do I have so far? Well, I have the pea, so let's go over here and see if we can make a beanstalk grow.
I order you to surrender, vile human!
I order you to the royal optometrist!
Perfect. It sank right into the ground. Now, if I know my fairy tales, this shouldn't take very long.
Unhand my nose, you stone-blind stalker!
King Allfire! What happened to Sir George? Am I in trouble?
Oh, I'd say you're in trouble.
Confound you, Gasflame! This is the last straw!
Oh, my word. Look at my poor tomato gloves.
Looks as though you've got brown roots, sire.
Blast it all. I've worked so hard on them.
There, there. If you like, I can give you my mum's recipe for fertilizer that will solve all your problems.
That's rather stand-up of you, Gasflame. All is forgiven with that earlier business. So anyway, how's your mum these days?
Married her last week. Dead, you know. Oh, just a minute, sire. Flicker, lad, thanks for the help.
It was my pleasure, Sir Knight. Just as it would be my pleasure to serve under you as your squire.
Oh, dash it all. You know me and squires. I'm a special case. As a token of my appreciation, though, here is a lump of Peruvian coal.
Gee, thanks. Coal.
Off to the square table room, Sir Gasflame. Follow me.
Your Highness is most resourceful.
Alright, now they settled their differences. Now, how about that naked man? Said he wanted a kiss from a princess, and that's just what we're gonna go get.
You must learn to accurately identify your enemies before you try to kill them. However, I am impressed by your bravery.
All part of the job, sire.
Once all my knights are back, we'll decide on a plan.
There's our moth, but we're not after him.
Flicker, this is my bedroom. Next time, knock, please.
Excuse me, Flame?
Flicker, have you done it? Are you a squire?
I'm close, Flame. Honest.
Hurry, Flicker. I refuse to marry against my will.
Can't you talk the king out of forcing you to marry? Use your feminine wiles. You know, smile sweetly. Lock him in a half, Nelson.
I've tried, but he reversed me into a figure four leg lock.
Flame?
Flicker?
Do you have any more advice about becoming a knight?
Nope. But here's a kiss for good luck.
Of course, you tried to catch it, but... Well, since the only thing we have to catch anything is this jar, let's try that.
Could we try that good luck kiss thing again?
There we go. Now that we got a kiss from a princess, let's take it to somebody who really needs it.
Kiss to turn you back into your original form. I imagine you'd giggle if you could. And most of your IQ went away when you transformed, didn't it? So I'm probably standing here talking to a frog who doesn't understand a word I say.
You're right, I'm a human.
But you can take him into your inventory. And why not? It's a video game.
You're right, I'm...
Now that we have Mr. Frog, let's take him to a lady friend. And we will now be able to free our next knight. Gee, French kissing for frogs. Who knew?
Are you recovered from that embarrassing bout of narcissism tonight?
Oh, yes, Flicker. That was indeed a torturous, yet somehow stimulating spell. Thank you for saving me.
I'd consider the debt paid in full if you would take me on as your squire.
Oh, bother. I'd love to, but I couldn't do a thing for you. I'm way over my squire quota. Try one of the other knights, lad. Come on now. No pouty faces. Here's a gift for you.
I'm honored, Sir Knight. This is clearly a family heirloom, handed down through generations.
Don't be silly. I have another 30 crates in my boudoir.
Well, nobody's accused him of being sentimental. Let's get out of here. Alright, now what? Now we gotta get him freed. In order to do that... We need a few extra implements. Let's go back to the castle first. Make sure that we check everything. Oh, yeah, and every time you walk past this lady, her... whatever, scarf, tail warmer, whatever, keeps getting longer and longer. Just keep an eye on that. It's really neat. Kind of hilarious.
Did you learn anything after visiting the pool, Sir Blaze?
No, sire. I hope it will not reflect poorly on me.
Interesting. I wonder what that means. Well, as soon as all my knights are back, we shall discuss what to do next.
All right, so now that the king is down here, where is the king's quarters? Where is it? Over here? I think it's up in here. Yep, here we are. All right, take some pipe cleaner.
I don't have sinus problems. But this pipe cleaner might come in handy.
And while we're at it, take this magazine.
I'll just take the Monarch Quarterly along in case I get a sudden bout of insomnia.
Huh. Yeah, you need that in order to go to sleep.
I am honored that King Allfire has one of my inventions in his bedroom. It's a shame it only tells the correct time twice a day.
Meaning the hands don't move. Nice going. Okay, I believe that's all we need right now, I think that is all we need right now. Okay, so let's go here, get out of here. And let's go to that village we never went to. So it's getting longer. It's getting longer. This is the village.
Lance, the royal mole, is ruining the streets of Camelot.
Now, you'll notice in this game, too, I believe, if I remember right, Cheech Marin has a lot of roles in this game. I think this is another one.
Excuse me, chef?
What do you want, the flicker? I'm busy, being upset.
What's the problem?
What isn't? It's been such a long time since I had a good laugh, you know? Like when you laugh so gosh darn hard, you think your heart, she's gonna explode?
Maybe it would help if I told you an amusing anecdote.
What's the matter, you? I'm not sick. I don't need no antidote.
Well, you need something to put a smile on your face. Excuse me, chef?
What do you want, the flicker? I'm busy, being upset.
What's the problem?
What isn't? It's been such a long time since I had a good laugh, you know? Like when you laugh so gosh darn hard, you think your heart, she's gonna explode?
Maybe it would help if I told you an amusing act.
Yeah, we already heard this.
Well, you need... Excuse me.
What do you want of...
Can Trivet cheer you up?
Ah, you crazy? Ah, that stupid dragon wouldn't know a joke even if I served it to him like a larger pizza with the extra apples.
Well, I know he's not that funny, but...
Funny? Ha! He's not even close. He makes me even more depressed than I am.
So, he really needs a good laugh. I don't know why, but he does. I think what we're after, though, is up here.
Hello up there. How's it going?
You say you're from the Union? Oh, I can't hear you way up here. Oh, I'm coming down.
I'm sorry, but I'm not from the Union.
Forget it, kid. It's time for a break anyway. The Sign Washers Union says we get a break every 13 minutes. You need a lot of breaks when you work on stilts, you know.
Okay, well, he's definitely Union. Let's take this pipe cleaner and pick up some termites. And now we got termites on a pipe cleaner. That's all we need right now. That's all we can do. At least for right now, anyway. So in order to free the next knight, we need to take this pipe cleaner to the Pied Piper.
Try this.
Must keep wooden pipe in perfect condition. I don't know what I'd do without my pipe. We're doomed! A total rat attack! Any second now, I'm going to be covered from head to toe with rats. Rats up my shirt, down my pants, in my shoes!
Hey, some people will count that
Stop
as a sexual experience.
What are you, cuckoo? Cut it out!
Strangers on the street will say, what a nice fur coat, what a nice fur coat, and I'll say, I'm not wearing a fur coat! I am covered with rats! Dirty, stinking, lousy rats!
Knock it off, you! The only rats around here are inside your head!
In my head? Oh my god! Get them out, get them out, get them out now!
Settle down! Relax! Relax!
Untie me, Flicker, hurry!
liquor. Good job, lad. I wish there was a way to show my gratitude.
And I wish that a grateful knight would make me a squire. If only there was some way both our wishes could come true.
You must subscribe to this archaic class system. Seek out Loungelon. However, I believe indentured servitude to be a degrading anachronism. Nonetheless, take this gift as a token of my gratitude.
Sir Knight, I don't know what to say. Except, what is this?
It was awarded to me when I deduced that the world was the shape of a duck.
Now it does sound like he needs to be committed.
Impressive.
Okay. Put the ribbon in there. And let's leave.
Hey! Sir Lancelot's out of the woods!
Alright, well, let's go over and talk to him.
Sir Loungelot, I've been looking all over for you.
I've been looking all over for the Black Dragon. I challenged the coward hours ago and he still hasn't engaged me in combat.
Combat? With him? Surely you jest.
No, I joust.
I thought the king only wanted you to get information about the Black Dragon.
King Allfire will forget all about that when I come home dragging the beast by its tail.
You expect the Black Dragon to come down here?
Why not? It's his turn. After all, I had to trudge all the way up the hill to challenge the brute. It's only fair he should come down to me for the battle.
Is there any way I can talk you out of this challenge?
No! It's a matter of honor now.
Sir Loungelot, about the Black Dragon.
This is no time for talking. I'm a dragon of action, and I'll sit here and wait for that dragon as long as I have to.
Well, while we're here, let's just take this.
Take this.
Wish we could take that woodpecker, but he's oblivious to our plan.
The Black Dragon is a machine. That makes sense. No self-respecting dragon would ever work for Sir George. That's Sir George. I guess he's testing the Black Dragon. That's Dog the Dog. Sir George's loyal dog. He's a clever little fellow. It's my guess that once they untie the rope, they'll hop in the treadmill and power that monstrosity up. If they'd just jump in and start running, I'll bet it would break free.
Test the machine, not my patience!
Should we get to do that?
Just another moment.
Do we have anything in our inventory just yet? I don't think we do.
We must conduct the test!
We are simple, underachieving peasants.
I don't think there's anything we can do right now.
No way! I'm not going out there!
We must conduct...
No, I've heard that dragons who expose themselves in these parts are subject to arrest.
We are simple, underachieving peasants.
Okay, well, I don't think that we can do anything right this second about that. Oh, I think I remember what we need to do. Okay. There's one thing we can do. And it's back in the village. We'll go to the arena. Now to the practice range. And now for the first interactive part of the game.
It's the Royal Catapult Target Range, where knights practice raining cats, but never dogs, against enemy castles.
Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to play a little target practice game.
All I have to do is aim the catapult, adjust the tension, and release. If I hit 9 out of 10 wooden knights, I get a shot at the big Sir George cutout for the win.
Okay, this is going to be fun.
Got it! That's one.
Not too high.
Darn, missed by a whisker. I can't miss again. Chalk up a second one. Missed too many. No use continuing on.
Took too long. All right, well, if that
all
happens, just
do
it again.
Aim the catapult. Adjust the tension.
Yeah, well, I've heard it all before.
Got it. That's one. Chalk up a second one.
That's the third one. Four down. Halfway there. That's five. Six. Got this by the tail. Seven down. Victory is near. That makes eight. Hey, that's nine.
Oops, missed that one. Ouch.
Darn, missed by a whisker. Can't miss again.
Oh,
darn,
missed
I
it.
Lose.
Oh, that was close. All right, one more time.
All I have to do is... Oh, that's one.
Just a quick tap of the button.
Chalk up a second one. Scratch the third one. Four down. Halfway there. That's five. Six. Got this by the tail.
Oops. Not long enough.
Seven down.
There
victory is near. That makes eight. I missed one, but I can still win. Hey, that's nine.
Damn, not long enough
missed
either.
Missed too many. No use continuing on. All I...
Yeah, it takes a little time to get used to the tension.
I got it. That's one. Chalk up a second one. Scratch the third one. Four down. Halfway there. That's five. Six. Got this by the tail.
Oh, darn it.
Seven down. Victory is near. That makes eight. Hey, that's nine. Bounced on ten.
Got him.
I did it. I win. I am master of the catapult range.
All right, well, he looks a little bit out of it, so let's take him along.
Poor fella took a lot of punishment. I'd better hold on to him.
Okay, now we can go back up that hill. Now we got a cat. Can't get the stilts yet, so we'll wait. Okay, now just go back to the map area, and we can just go right over to the hill. And we'll just see how well the dog is taken with the cat. This can't possibly be good. Then again, yes, it could. Alright, here we are. Let's find that kitty. Come here, kitty.
The machine, not my...
Into those redwood trees, coward! Some warrior you are!
Slug-brained simpletons! This is all your fault!
Sir Loungelot, what happened?
Did you not see it yourself? First, the fiend was not alone. He brought several of his friends.
No doubt it's a grand tale, but first, I have something to ask you.
Very well, what is it?
You know I admire you, don't you?
I'm not sure I like where this is going, Flicker. If you get funny on me, you'll regret it.
I'm looking for a knight to squire under.
And you want me to be that knight? Out of the question. You're not qualified.
On a mission like this, you wear chainmail?
Yes, what of it?
Mail is fine if you're conquering a continent, but for tracking down dragons, I would have picked out a light wool. While tracking, you need to be light on your feet.
You seem to know quite a bit about battlefield wear. I've just now decided that you will be my new squire.
If you insist.
'Tis settled. Now, here's something I think you will need.
Soap?
Not common soap, simpleton. It's my privately blended laundry detergent for my undergarments, which I expect my squire to scrub every morning.
Sir Loungelot, I'm overwhelmed by your generosity.
You're very welcome. Now, back to Camel Hot so I can tell the others of my grand battle.
Oh, yes, your grand battle. The Black Dragon runs you over and you're going to tell everybody that you've conquered all.
King Allfire, the Black Dragon has been defeated.
Say what?
Good work, Sir Loungelot. You will make a fine king and husband to my lovely flame when you win the... if you win the tournament tomorrow.
I am not about to stand here and be given away as a prize in a contest.
Blast it all. Flicker, see if you can cool flames a bit, would you?
Yes, your firm but fair dictatorship, but first I have vital news about the Black Dragon.
What could you possibly have to report, my puny squire?
That the Black Dragon is actually... a machine!
Okay, knight, settle down. We shall resume later. Flicker, now please go watch Princess Flame for me.
All right, your purple mountain's majesty.
I'm running away.
But I just became a squire, Flame. If I make knighted by tomorrow, I can win your hand in the tournament.
Sorry, can't chance it. Now, help me find something to lower out the window for me to climb down.
Well, since we don't have that, this makes it a perfect opportunity to
it's
take a bit
like
of a break.
To escape or anything.
Yeah, well, let me just put you on pause. So now, what do you say we just take a little break and we will return and resume in our next video for Let's Play Blazing Dragons. I'm SonicBlu, see you next time.